in the bench spots. This is a review of the Joseph Parker and Hugh Fury fight. Joseph Parker successfully defended his title against Hugh Fury, who is a cousin or nephew of Tyson Fury, the Nuthead former heavyweight champion. I watched glimpses of this fight here and there. I couldn't get a good source to watch the fight from, so I caught glimpses of the fight. Hugh Fury came into this fight and was running for his dear life. He didn't want to engage in any way, shape or form. All he did was run. He was constantly backpedaling. Joseph Parker was chasing the guy throughout the ring, time and time again throughout the rounds. He didn't back Joseph Parker up at any point in the fight. I was shocked and I was surprised. I thought this fight would be at least a little bit competitive. But the guy just didn't want to engage whatsoever with Joseph Parker. He didn't want no pass of Joseph Parker in any sort of exchange. I don't know if he thinks he has a suspicion or whatever the case is. This guy didn't want to engage in any way, shape or form. He was constantly backpedaling. Joseph Parker also showed some deficiencies in this fight because he couldn't close the ring. He didn't close up the distance between him and he was just chasing this guy all over the ring, time and time again. He couldn't cut the ring off, like how Triple G is able to do. He can't cut the ring off. All you do is just chasing the guy all over the ring and exerting so much energy. The fight was not just... I wasn't really impressed with the way the fight panned out because I was expecting a little bit of a competitive fight. Considering the fact that both fighters are undefeated fighters. But Hugh Fury had other ideas. He just came to just survive in this fight. The moment the fight started, the guy was in survival mode immediately. He didn't have any desire to change his game plan, to do something else. And interesting enough, he expected to win the fight. After the fight, he actually thought he won. And his, his relative, Tyson Fury, came to make a fool of himself like he always does. He never disappoints. Came to the ring and he was just misbehaving as usual, thinking his relative had won the fight. You expect to win a fight in this fashion. You came to the fight, all you do is backpedal. You don't back up your opponent at any point in the fight. You are not willing to engage. All you are doing is running away and hoping to pop, catch him, counter. That's all he's relying on, countering. Run away and just giving some petty pop shots. You expect to win a fight like that. That's actually the way Tyson Fury won the fight against Wladimir Klitschko, but he was a little bit more effective than this. He was actually willing to engage at some points in the fight. But this guy, he had no desire to exchange. Just came into a fight and keep constantly on your heels, running away. It's just sad and disappointing. Because I had high hopes for this fight. Anyway, Joseph Parker got the job done and he defended his title. Now he has a score to settle with either Anthony Joshua or Wilder. Wilder has Luis Ortiz problems, so I think Joshua also has a fight with Pulev. So Parker will have to wait in the wings for a while. But I've said in the past that Joseph Parker, I don't think he's a threat to any of the heavyweight champions currently. I don't think so. I think he's the weakest champion among the champions of the heavyweight division. I'm not too sure how he's going to hold up against this other, either Anthony Joshua or Deontay Wilder. I just don't fancy his chance against them. So we'll see what the future holds for the heavyweight division. This is my thoughts for now. If you like the comment, subscribe and give it a thumbs up. Thank you for your time and catch you in the next video. Bye for now.